10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Sulla casta.
An Italian Space Agency's podcast. The characters and exploits of man's great adventure to conquer space. Astro Samantha.
Chissà domani su che cosa metteremo le mani, se si potrà contare ancora le onde del mare e alzare la testa, non essere così seri.
Samantha Cristoforetti, born April the 26th, 1977 in Milan, Italy. Distinctive features: engineer, retired Air Force pilot officer with the rank of captain, is an astronaut, first Italian woman to fly into space. Languages spoken: Italian, English, French, German, and Russian. She's currently studying Chinese. Call sign: Astro Samantha. Yes, this is Samantha Cristoforetti. Her biography states that as a child, she became mesmerized with space when gazing into the sky in Malé, her hometown in Val di Sole, in the Trentino Alto Adige region, Italy. But there is so much more that describes Samantha. Her perseverance above all and a great passion for mathematics and logic, along with a thirst for adventure, curiosity, and a keen eye for other countries and other cultures. She studied in France and Russia and graduated from the Technical University of Munich, Germany, with a master's degree in mechanical engineering. As part of her training at the Italian Air Force Academy in Pozzuoli, Samantha also completed a bachelor's degree in aeronautical sciences. She earned her fighter pilot wings at Shepherd Air Force Base in the United States. She was a captain of the Italian Air Force. Samantha was selected as an ESA astronaut on May the 18th, 2009. In her memoirs, Diary of an Astronaut Apprentice, she shares her emotions of that memorable day. I was still sitting on my bed when I got an email that made me jolt. It was from ESA. I clicked on it in a rush, expecting it to be about setting a time for a phone call and a phone number. Instead, it was a short, dry, and technical sentence that melted away my tension in no time at all. Before going to sleep, I glanced at the small patch of sky I could see from my window. One day, I told myself, when I will be aboard the International Space Station, I too will be a bright little dot up there. Talent, hard work, and an iron will are the key features of this woman with an irresistible smile. Skilled in using social media as a means of communication, the first TikToker astronaut, followed and loved by young people as if she were a character out of a game, a movie, a comic book. Interviewed by Modern Barbie, Astro Samantha is also able to speak and reach out to the youngest generations, urging them to study and keep an open mind. Here is her advice from Mattel's blog live from the ISS in 2022. At least as long as you are in school, you should devour just about anything that comes your way. It's important you have as broad an education as possible. So delve into math and physics, but also learn history, philosophy, and the humanities, because no matter what you do in life, you should be a complete person. Cristoforetti completed her ESA basic astronaut training in 2010 in Cologne. She then traveled to Japan, Russia, Canada, and the United States for advanced training. Her training entailed dozens of hours inside simulators to learn how to fly a Soyuz spacecraft. And finally, she became a flight engineer. November the 23rd, 2014 marks yet another key day in Samantha's life. Shortly after 10 p.m. Italian time, a Russian Soyuz rocket blasted off from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to deliver three new crew members to the International Space Station. The launch was perfect. The Soyuz capsule was holding our astronaut Samantha, along with an American astronaut and a Russian cosmonaut, because in the sky there are no barriers and no walls whatsoever. That was the beginning of Futura, the second long-duration mission for Italy's ASI space agency, following Luca Parmitano's Volare mission in 2013. Samantha remained for 6 months in orbit about 400 kilometers from Earth in that large interdisciplinary laboratory dedicated to scientific research and managed as a joint project by five different space agencies. This is how she described that experience in her memoirs published by Nave di Teseo. There is the Earth down below, blue as befits, with splashes of white casting long shadows over the sea. I can catch a glimpse of the Milky Way and recognize Cassiopeia. They are as far away as Earth, but from here it seems as if we can converse. There is something poignant about contemplating it from up here. From this metal box, this tangle of not even too cutting-edge technology that allows us to be here where no human being should be. Astro Samantha returned to Earth on June the 11th, 2015, after spending 199 days in space, where she also found the time to record her version of John Lennon's iconic Imagine for UNICEF. Listen to it.
Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of man.
From 2015 onward, Cristoforetti traveled, studied, and experimented. In 2019, she moved from deep space to the ocean depths, serving as commander for NASA's 23rd Extreme Environment Mission Operations, NEMO 23. Onboard Aquarius, the world's only undersea research station, placed 19 meters below sea surface off the coast of Florida. This habitat is where aquanauts can simulate life on board a spacecraft, including spacewalks, since water is the most space-like environment we have here on Earth. In 2021, Samantha was assigned to the Minerva mission. The mission's name is a tribute to the Roman goddess who, as the astronaut explained, embodies the toughness and discipline that is required of us, and the wisdom we wish to demonstrate as we consolidate and expand human presence in space. On April the 27th, 2022, the day after Cristoforetti's 45th birthday, at 9:52 a.m., the SpaceX Crew 4 mission took off from the John Fitzgerald Kennedy Space Center with the ESA astronaut and three other crew members on board. On July the 21st, 2022, Astro Samantha was the first one to step out of the International Space Station, floating 400 kilometers above the Earth. For 6.5 hours, she worked in the cosmic vacuum, completing the first spacewalk a European woman astronaut in a Russian orbital spacesuit ever did. It was a thrill ride. Her record-breaking achievements do not end here, though. On September the 28th, she was appointed commander of the ISS. Samantha Cristoforetti returned to Earth after 170 days on October the 14th, 2022.
Salirò fino a quando sarò solamente un punto lontano.
Thanks for listening to Look Up, an Italian Space Agency's podcast. The characters and exploits of man's great adventure to conquer space. Script, Daniela Amenta. Post-production, Paola Pagone. Editorial coordination, Giuseppina Pulcrano and Manuela Proietti.